الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله داعي إلى رضوانه أما بعد أحبتي في الله أيها المسلمون الكرام أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون All thanks and praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the universe. We thank Him. As Muslims, we testify that there is none worthy of worship and praise except Allah and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final and seal of all prophets and messengers Allah sent to guide mankind from the darkness of disobedience towards the nur of Iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst the guided ones of Kareem. My dear brothers and sisters in the deen, fathers as well as mothers, I first of all admonish myself standing before you and all of you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah. Allah says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. He called on you the believers, O you who believe. Ittaqullaha haqqa tuqati. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he ought to be feared. Wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. And do not die except in the state of Islam. Ahibbati fillah. My dear beloved ones, حينما خلق الله آدم عليه السلام, when Allah created Adam, أمر الملائكة أن يسجدوا له. Allah commanded the angels to prostrate to Adam عليه السلام, a prostration of honor. فسجد الملائكة كلهم أجمعين. All the angels they prostrated to Allah, to Adam alayhi salam, illa, except Iblis. Iblis, Satan or Shaitan. Allah said, Aba wastakbara wa kana min al kafirin. Iblis, la'natullahi alayhi. He denied, disobeyed Allah. He became arrogant and disbelieved. He said, Allah, I am not going to prostrate for Adam. Never would I do that prostration for him. Why? He said, خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَار وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِن تِين. You created me from fire, a smokeless fire, and you created him from clay. So I will not do that. I am better than him. That's where it started. I am. You are. They are. My tribe. My clan. That's how it started. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, He said, Ya ayyuhal nas. In Surah Nisa, he said, O you mankind, اتقوا ربكم, fear your Lord. Fear your Lord, your Creator. الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة. The Lord who created you from a single soul, from Adam عليه السلام. Fear the Lord who created you from a single soul. وخلق منها زوجها. And from that soul, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created its partner. And that is Eve, Hawa. وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً. And from Adam and Hawa, all of us derived. Look at us today. Different race, different color, different tribes, different dialects. But why did Allah create us like that? But Allah said here in the ayah, He said, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامِ. And fear Allah through whom you demand things from one another. And Allah said, also as well, you cherish the ties of the womb. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا. For indeed, Allah is ever watchful over you. The Quran, my dear brothers and sisters in the deen, if you read the Quran as a Muslim, which is very unfortunate today for the Muslims or the so-called Muslims who do not read the Quran, let alone observe their prayer. See the masjid, how full it is? Before the khutbah starts, maybe half an hour, the masjid is full. Why? They said it's Good Friday. Is there any bad Friday? You are a Muslim. Yeah. That's how it is. But the noble Quran, the Quran that you have, you as a Muslim, you only have one constitution, and that is the Quran and the Sunnah. Allah said, وَأَتِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَتِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. Obey Allah and His Messenger. That's all you have. And that Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That book, there is no doubt in it. It's a guidance. Not for everyone. Allah said, for those who are God conscious. Not for everyone. If you fear Allah, then that book is your guide. The Quran underlines fine human relations based on the goodly words, purposeful dialogue, and also as well, good treatments and kind forgiveness. That's what the Quran underlines for us. It promotes peace and harmony. Not only that, it urges us to abstain from causes of division, destruction, disunity and hatred. That's what the Quran promotes myself and you towards. The Quran did not just demonstrate things to us verbally, but it teaches us how to demonstrate the deen. Here you are. We are sitting now. You cannot distinguish between the wealthy and the poor. You cannot distinguish between the most knowledgeable one amongst us here and the illiterate. In Islam, when you come to the masjid, when you come first, you sit on the first line, right? And you sit as you come. So there is no difference. No one has a special treatment in the masjid. Allah said, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The most honorable one to Allah amongst us here is the one who fears Allah the most. No one else. And you don't know that person. Only Allah knows. And that's why Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ أَوْ يُّ مَنْكَيْنِ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى. I created you as males and females. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا. and I put you into tribes and nations so that you may know each other. That's why Allah puts us into tribes and nations. Not to fight for a tribe. Not to fight in the name of tribalism. Not to fight in the name of a clan or belonging or whatever. No. Allah said, Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. The most honorable one amongst you are those who fear Allah. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the fear will summon. He said, Ayyuhan nas, said, O you mankind, Isma'u minni, ubayyinu lakum, fa inni la adri la'alli la alqaakum ba'da aami hadha. He said, listen to me attentively, for I do not know if I will witness the year to come. But listen to this message. Then the Prophet Muhammad said, he said, Ayyuhan nas, O you mankind, Inna Rabbakum Wahid, your Lord is one, only one God. Do not commit shirk. Don't commit shirk, juju, as you call it. Consult that man to tell you that this is your future. What do I have to do? Write something, hang it here, put it by your side. It cannot protect you. And Allah said, وَمَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ ضَلَالًا مُبِينًا. Said, anyone who goes to a soothsayer, you believe that person, you commit shirk, and you die in that, Allah said, he will never forgive you. That's the only sin he will never forgive. So if you have done that before, put a stop to it from today, and repent to Allah. He said, Inna Rabbakum al-Wahid, your Lord is one. And also as well, your father, Abakum Wahid, your father is one, only Adam. You can't tell me Adam was from Africa, Adam was from Asia, Arab. Adam was only one being on the surface of this earth. And Eve was only one mother. One mother. You can't tell me she was an Irish, she was an American, she was an African. Akhir Kareem, your father, my father, your mother and my mother, they are only one. One father and one mother, all of us derived. So when you look at your brother, you look at his color, you laugh at them, or you discriminate them, you are discriminating yourself. Because you are all from what? Adam min turab. Adam is from the dust. Wa kullukum min turab. You are all from dust. That's you. You're nothing but dust. When you die, they lay you on this floor. Even the one who washes your body, they lay you on the board or just the floor, washing your body. You cannot say to them, brother, look, make this water become lukewarm. Dilute it, please. Because it's too cold, or it's too warm, or it's too hot. But you have no power to say that again. And when they take you to your grave, your pillow is the mud. Your bed is this mud. So why boasting? Why arrogance? Be humble, ya akhi. Be humble. You will leave this dunya as you came. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, there is no superiority for the Arabs over the non-Arabs, nor the non-Arabs over the Arabs, nor the whites over the black, nor the black over the whites, because you are all from Adam, your brothers and sisters. Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, he told Bilal, he said, Yabna Sawda, he said, oh, you the son of a black mother. This is Sahabi, a disciple. And then the Prophet Muhammad said, Ya Abu Dharr,
He said, O you Abu Dharr, a'yartahu bi ummi? Did you call his mother names? Did you attribute color to his mother? And listen to what he said. He said, innaka mru'un fika jahiliya. He said, you are a man who is suffering from the disease of ignorance. Pre-Islamic time, someone who does not understand the deen, you're suffering from that. And this goes to anyone who discriminates, who fights in the name of tribalism. The Prophet Muhammad said, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَذْهَبَ عَنْكُمْ عُبِيَّةَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. He said, Allah has removed from you the pride of pre-Islamic period, the Jahiliyyah. He has removed it from you because he brought Islam, ya akhi. It's a blessing. Not only that, it said, وَفَخْرَهَا بِالْآبَاءِ. It said, and it's boasting about lineage. I'm from this tribe. I'm from that tribe. Your tribe will not do you any good. يوم القيامة. Allah said, يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. The day when your son, your child, your daughter, your mother, your father will not benefit you. Wallahi will not benefit you that day. إِلَّا مَنَ أَطَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Except if he, or the one who comes to Allah with a tranquil mind, the peace that attain, the heart that attain Iman, faith in Allah. The Prophet Muhammad said, إِنَّمَا هُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ تَقِيٌّ أَوْ فَاجِرٌ شَقِيٌّ. He said, a person can only be a pious believer or a miserable sinner. That's all. So don't boast about tribal. And listen to this hadith. The Prophet Muhammad said, Laysa minna. He is not part of us, i.e. he will not be amongst the true believers yawm al-qiyamah to enter al-jannah. Who? He said, Man da'a ila asabiyya. Anyone who invites, advocates in the name of tribalism, in the name of sect, ism, he's not part of the Muslims. Subhanallah. Imagine, you have your daughters, you have your sons. When someone comes from another background to marry your daughters, no. He has to be this tribe. Allahu Akbar. No. Where are you from? What's your tribe? Ya akhi. Nuh alayhi salam, his son was not a believer. Did he benefit from the prophecy of his father? No. And he said, وَلَيْسَ مِنَّا مَنْ قَاتَلَ عَلَى عَصَبِيَّةٍ. He said, anyone who dies in the name of tribalism, racialism, he will not be amongst us. He will not be amongst the believers in Al-Qiyam. وَلَيْسَ مِنَّا مَنْ مَاتَ على عصبية. Sorry, من قاتل. He said, anyone who fights in the name of tribalism, and anyone who dies as well in the name of tribalism, he will not be amongst the believers, amongst us, يوم القيامة. So don't do that. You have to humble yourself. Put yourself down. When you humble yourself, Allah will raise you above. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of us. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We thank Allah and the peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters in the deen, we are going through difficult moments and times as Muslims. What do we need to do?
This is the time we need to present and show the deen, our deen, to the non-Muslims and everyone. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he said, invite to the path of Allah without saying a word. And then they said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, how is that possible for me to invite someone to Islam without saying a word? He said, bi akhlaqik, through your character, your manners. Your manners, this is what we're suffering from. Now we're all humble in the masjid, mashallah. A Muslim, your character justifies your identity. You are a Muslim, be a Muslim. Allah said, Udkhulu fi silmi kafa, enter into the religion wholeheartedly. But subhanallah, a Muslim does not pray. They only pray Fridays to Fridays. And today, as I started my speech, I said the masjid is full. Why? Because it's Good Friday. And someone will call you Sheikh. Happy Good Friday. Yahi. Happy Good Friday. So all the Fridays I had was a bad one. And the best day of the week, the Rasulullah said, is Yawmul Jum'ah, is on Friday. Why do you worship Allah on Friday? Why only Friday? Listen to this. Those who do not pray, those who only worship time to time, you're gonna die soon, ya akhi. Death is awaiting for you. In fact, you are waiting for death. Because Allah said, إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. The death that you are running away from, it will surely meet you. Wherever you are, you will die. If you do not pray, you do not observe the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Know what Allah says in the Quran. He said, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ. There will be a punishment in the day of judgment for those who pray. Not those who do not pray, those who pray. Who? الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. Those who are neglectful in their prayer. How many times you pray Taraweeh in your house? Why do I call it Taraweeh? Because they go to work. When they return home, that's when they pray 5 daily, all the 5 prayers. They pray it in 10 minutes. They pray all 5. Like a chicken eating some seeds or whatever. Yahi, Allah gave you 24 hours. And He said, give me at least just 25 minutes to worship me. And you don't do it. And that's the purpose of creation. Allah said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I do not create man and jinn but to worship me. Observe your prayer. Teach your children, your family to observe prayer, salah, to worship Allah. Teach them. The children, they come to the madrasa and we will ask them, did you pray? No, I didn't pray. Even my dad does not pray. أتأمرون الناس بالبر وتنسون أنفسكم وأنتم تتلون الكتاب. Why do you admonish someone to do something good and you leave yourself out? Why? Why do you tell the daughter to put on the hijab and the mother, she goes out there, even chaka chaka? Yeah. Why do you tell the boy to pray, to be a good Muslim, and you, the father, you have cigarettes by your mouth? And then some will say, cigarette is not haram. Who told you? Because you don't know Islam. That's why. It's there in the Quran. Why do you smoke? وَلَا تُلْقُوا أَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى تَحَلُّكَ. Allah said, do not stretch your hands. Don't buy that which destroy you. Why? Why do you swear in front of the children? Why do you curse as a Muslim? Allah said about the Rasulullah, He said, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَذِيمٍ. He did not say to him, you are the best of all worshippers, because he used to stand in the night until his feet become swollen. But Allah praised him of one thing. He said, you are the best in character. Manners, humbleness, good words, and sincere words. Don't swear at parents. Finally, for the young ones here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقَدَ رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا.
Your Lord has decreed that you must not worship except Him, and then show kindness to your parents. We are in London, ya akhi. You will be surprised to know that how many husbands have thrown their mothers and fathers from their houses because of their wives. How many as well, the opposites? How many children stood up there, looked at their parents and disrespected them? The Rasulullah said, three categories of people. La yanzur Allahu ilayhim yawm al-qiyamah. Allah will not look at them. In other words, He will not have mercy on them the day of judgment. Wa la yukallimuhum. Allah will not talk to them either. Wa lahum adhabun alim. They have painful punishments yawm al-qiyamah. The first one, He said, al-aqli waliday. The one who swear at his parents or disrespect his parents, Allah will not forgive you, except if they forgive you. Some of the curse, the problems we are facing, is because of how we treat our parents. If you want to be blessed, go to your parents, call them, seek forgiveness, and honor them. Because without them, you don't have been who you are today. If you're driving car, they drove car before you. If you have knowledge, they taught you how to speak. So they are more knowledgeable than you. So Islam is encouraging me and you to be a good Muslim. May the brothers and sisters in the day, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive each and every one of us. Amen. Those who are sick amongst us, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cure them. Those who are going through trial, tribulations, problems, temptations, may Allah ease their path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us live, die, and be worthy of judgment as far as possible.
La yazalu al-khayru hayyan la yazal. Inna fi al-dunya